still doesn't let me see it. Said it still doesn't let me see it. I'm supposed to be playing defense.
This one away, and boy, it's another boomer.
Like, I just want to watch Madden play. I don't want to play Madden. Like, why is it so hard, man? What happened?
What, coaching mode?
Yeah, like, I just want to call the plays and just watch it.
Like the off-road walk. We just try to make the whole crowd go nuts, right?
Your season starts now.
If I could just do that then.
Guy is Russell Wilson. Because guess what? He ain't that fast. And in the NFL, everyone's running 4-4s, 4-3s, and they're about 6-4, 6-5.
Your season starts now.
Don't say Drew Brees. Don't say Drew Brees.
Ugh. I knew it. Somehow I knew you were gonna say that. Are you kidding me?
Of course, because you're short.
Start the regular season by selecting your season goal. Meeting your season goal gives high rewards, but does come with
a
more stability around them. I don't even know if you're gonna fucking, if Hugh Jackson is gonna be the coach next year if they have a losing season.
Jones. Penalty. Keem Spence. 3-yard rush, Ronald Jones. Minus 3 yards, Ronald Jones. 3 yards. Right.
So now here come the Dolphins. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. But I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room in pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
Trying to find some space to operate, and now they'll have it. A gain of 12, a big first down to get away from the end zone. Play fake here on first down. His throw incomplete. Devontae Parker, the intended receiver, and now it's second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Tannehill on first down. It's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
The gun on third down, Tannehill.
Got a sack. Good shit, Vita. Oh, wow. Tannehill just ran for 26 yards. Tannehill.
Why are you playing them again?
Because I'm trying something different. I'm playing just man, one player. Yeah, but I set up the franchise like that, where even if I wanted to play other players, I can just play Vita Vea. to reception to Chris Godwin. Yeah. 5 yards, Ronald Jones. Come on, let's get us a touchdown. Touchdown, Chris Godwin. Yes. All right. It's the best. I wish I could actually watch it happen, but. This is the only way that my offense could actually be normal. Like my quarterback actually try to throw the ball and stuff like that.
By doing what?
By letting it simulate like that. Oh, nigga. Oh, he was after you. For reals.
I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Throwing on third down, Tannehill.
Ah.
Take off on him, Tanny. To let them know. And no, they forgot you was the best receiver on your fucking college team, nigga. They keep forgetting. Keep not putting the spider out for Tanny.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they gotta get ready. It's first and goal. Now flags will come in. I think this one's gonna be on the defense for jumping.
Oh.
Linebacker.
So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
Come on, Ventures. Yep, that's definitely something you should come on into.
Tannehill.
The blocking. Again, take off from him, Tanny. Let him know, Tanny. They just gonna keep, like, not trusting your leg. Like you're gonna run a 4, 5, 6, nigga. Stop that shit. They get the ball back. Alright, Tim, let's get three out of here. They put you in a banging field position. Got two timeouts.
That
no problem.
That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is.
Second and 10, Tannehill.
Oh, come on. You could have waited a little bit more.
Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what?
Play is fine.
From the gun, here's Tannehill.
And
Devontae Parker was one of three Miami receivers of over 700 yards last year, along with Jarvis Landry and Kenny Stills. But I do know this, they'd love to have one of them emerge and be that 1,000-yard guy. And take the pressure off of everyone else.
On first down, it's Tannehill.
Take off of him, Tan. Take off of you, Tan. Oh, that's not it. Another first down. Hey, yo. Tan about to have 100 rushing yards on you, bro. He about to have 100 rushing yards on you. Y'all, he got 75.
On first and 10, Tannehill. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they'll be inside the 25 now. At the 24. Off.
And get out of bounds, really.
A timeout. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. On second down, here's Tannehill.
Wow.
Get away, get away, get away. Let's go. Let's go, Tan. Let's go. Let's go. It's not like a Jacob Timmy ball.
Oh, wow.
All right, sat by Robert Quinn. Oh, Donovan Smith injured. Oh, come on. Oh, stop, stop. Let's go, Kiko.
Dolphins now, they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter. So time to
meet up.
They probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively.
Oh, get a partner.
This isn't working, and it's shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little.
Ah, hit him, come on.
But I think I need to get somebody on him.
Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Yes. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Counterplay, Drake.
Come on, I'm on them, bro. Should be stopped.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be
spy.
Here's Tannehill. And he will take it in for a
Damn, yo, he's a second, bro. He just throwing on the line. Darts.
Chris Godwin's eating in this game. Oh, Jameis Winston just got injured.
Damn, sack for 8 yard loss and he got injured on the play. Damn.
Oh, he's still in there.
Still playing though.
Toughening it out.
Oh wow, 4-14-4. Got it. Oh, King Spence, you know what that is.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh wow. Somebody did another penalty. What? Come on.
And out come the Dolphins now. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is a defense
that's going to have one of those fumbles.
So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Injured. Come on.
Good stuff, Quan.
Situation when you're up in the fourth quarter, they're gonna have to stack the box and make it difficult.
That was Kenny when he got the head off.
Right there, now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's gonna take to slow him down.
Come on, man, let that ball come out. You're just catching everything.
And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time.
Cool.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this.
Oh, come.
Tell you what they're and make sure that they're still
Drag them, boy. For sure.
As to leave too much time on the clock. And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop.
What happened last year?
Pastor, you said big third down. I put the word big in capital letters here. Given 15 yards on that one.
DJ Durbin. Like, you just seem slow, bro. Why are you so slow?
That's how it is.
I mean, I know I got a fast team. Besides Amendola, everybody running 4-4. 4-3, sub 4-3 and shit.
Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap this one up after this. As we welcome you back in, and the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. They stay on the ground with Drake.
Just second.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain.
Say, get that block, say. There you go, say. There you go.
Left with 3rd and 6.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carried around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class?
Hey. The Jets, they have taken the lead late now over the Bills. Jermaine Curse, he had a touchdown reception to help the cause.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them.
Well, offense did good. Week 2.
Just shy of the 25. Showed some of that quickness there on the move. The numbers there for Howard a week ago. 16 carries, 70 yards.
That's a good start to the season. They got the win and they were able to establish it.
Penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Ronald Jones injured. Mike Evans heart hurt. But they don't know no better.
Yeah.
sets up a third down. I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slam. It goes for a gain of 10, and it's a first down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, we'll send you to Orlando and Larry Ridley, as he'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. But no touchdowns. You guys need to get there some touchdowns to talk about.
Things are too easy for him right now back in the studio. Come on, guys. Help the man out. Give him something to talk about.
And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. The Bears on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. To the air again, Daniel. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Trey Burton, his 2nd touchdown on the offense now getting ready to take over. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start planning for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Another panic. It's a mirage. I got my fans to sabotage.
Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, how they just sit on it.
Situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead, finish up the half, and get on out and talk about it.
Give them 40 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not much happening there on first down.
Thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, they dropped it pretty quickly. They get closed fast.
Sabotage.
And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play.
Philosophy at this point going to make that defense stand up and stop them. They'll run it now out of the gun. Now, how extraordinary.
this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it.
I forgot that shit from Problem Child.
There's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. He'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game.
I don't want that. I gotta have that
right out of my mouth so far. Four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here, we do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Pushing the back. Yeah. That's right.
Goku versus Superman, the animated.
I just can't, like...
Superman had a power up. How come, like, Americans, you don't got no cop power ups? Like,
second down, goal to go from the six. Now Howard trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage.
Cause we never care about the next level. America's never planning ahead.
Superman get like a Kryptonian power up.
Hey.
His hair spikes up.
Another sack by Vita Vea.
Or like a bang on his hair moves up. Powers up like a red glow around Superman and shit. Goku would love to fight Superman.
First down, got his hand complete over the middle. That's
Are you cooking the food now?
Yeah. You wanna know?
You eating now? Are you eating right now?
Yeah. Oh. Why you didn't want it now?
I guess. What time is it?
First they go right back to Howard. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36 yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know your defense has to do it as well. You gotta stop them here. We're gonna see that loading the
ball. Well, I gotta get ready to eat. Play where? Skinny Bone Jones is hungry. Go play for a little bit. Go play for a little bit. Oh, I never forgot to tell you something. Yeah. But we'll see if we can do it on TV. Random movie.
The time.
What?
You barely be holding in the smoke before you start it off.
Should go straight to my throat. Overboard. Oh.
So don't hit it as hard so you can hold it in. Somebody come off your nose. Then blow the smoke off your nose.
I do blow the smoke out my nose. Huh? No, I'm talking about this movie.
What is he about to do?
That's a new one.
What is this? What is he about to do?
Beach and get fries and a drink with the $3.49 King Meal deal. Only at Burger King.
I'm Jim McGain, and I wish I could tell you how to do something like this. And that includes a bit harder.
Hold on.
Different ideas. It's not just about being a slogan fest out there. It's about having these sort of replicable goals that you can possibly put together.
Goku.
Forming what you want your team to be. That's where it starts with the Bears. Then they're going to try to win some games.
As I said, we have quarterbacks, we have coaches, we have a new head coach, a young quarterback. There is so much interesting.
It's just a different dimension type of Superman.
Thank you, Tom Pelissero and Stacey Bales, about the NFL. Remiss as we talk Vikings here without mentioning Tony Sperano. The league is just really in shock, and we are still mourning out the passing of the former head coach of Miami Dolphins yesterday. He's 56 years old as he was getting ready to head with his family to church. The former interim head coach of the Raiders as well is such a welcome face in any locker room you walked into over the years. The longtime assistant coach, Tony Sperano. This statement here from Rick Spielman, the Vikings GM. Sperano's been the O-line coach the last few years for the Vikings. At a loss for words with Tony suddenly asking, he loved the game of football and his players. More importantly, he was a strong man of faith who treasured his family. My heart is with the Speranos today. As an organization, we will support them in whatever ways we can. That again from the GM of the Vikings, Rick Spielman, from the Dolphins. Our thoughts and prayers are family and friends of Coach Tony Sperano, last head coach not named Bill Belichick for the AFC East. Tony Sperano, Jake Long was on that team, former left tackle.
Bring it over here.
I'm at such a loss for words and beyond.
Yeah.
Sad to hear about the passing.
Yeah, I'm gonna drink it. Sperano, I'm gonna drink it. Yeah.
So much to me, I respected the coach, the way he loved football. Approached the game. Most of all, I respected the way he loved his family so much and how good of a father.
You want to use the no?
No.
He was the first to believe in me in the NFL, the first to give me my shot, the only one who always stood by me through thick and through thin throughout my career, and the last one to believe in me in my last career. He taught me so much, and I am so grateful for him. I'm humbled and honored to have known him and played for him. I love you, Coach.
She continued.
Rest in peace. Tony Sperano was 56 years old.
And died 49 days before.
I stand on the shoulders of these great men, and with all of you on this stage tonight, never let others cry.
Enshrinement ceremony, Saturday, August 4th at 7, live on NFL Network.
Sam Adams, Summer Am, the official.
Bro, football is just so official. I said football is just so official.
Not so much this.
Like, football players are superheroes.
It tastes pretty great with that. Because it's summer.
Yeah.
Nothing goes better with that than this. Sam Adams Summer Ale. Clear your glass.
This school year, get a new iPhone from T-Mobile and keep your whole family connected. Or keep tabs on them.
He skipped orientation for the beach.
Oh,
he takes after me.
Join team. Buy an iPhone 8. Get an iPhone 8 on us.
Lease the 2018 IS300 and IS300 all-wheel drive for these terms.
Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
How do you all know each other?
We're slingers.
We sling. Let's move this party inside.
With sling, it's easy to watch all the live TV we want.
Without paying for channels we don't need.
Oh, sling.
What did you think we were doing?
Start slinging for $25 a month. Play your first 7 days free.
Introducing
Rust-Oleum Wipe New. Just wipe it on and instantly restore weathered, sun-damaged vehicles. Just one wipe will keep your vehicle looking like new for years to come. Nothing else compares in ease, durability, and staying power. Wipe New's groundbreaking formula outperforms traditional brands and has created a new standard that cannot be duplicated. Wipe New's headlight will instantly repair foggy, discolored headlights and keep them looking brand new. Rust-Oleum Wipe New products are guaranteed. And available at fine retailers.
The Eagles are Super Bowl champions. Fly Eagles Fly. Celebrate with the gear the Eagles wore as they hoisted the Vince Lombardi Trophy.
The Eagles won a Super Bowl.
Towels, the players wore with pride after their historic victory. You were there for every catch, every touchdown, every moment. Relive the celebration with the official Super Bowl 52 DVD.
Tomorrow on NFL Total Access, Dallas Cowboys prepping for the new season. Bears and Ravens prepping for the Hall of Fame game. Darrell Revis prepping for the Hall of Fame.
How much does it matter that your team has never won a Super Bowl?
What is that?
I said, how much does it really matter that your team has never won a Super Bowl?
The ATL.
They don't know.
To a team that hasn't won one.
They still did find a way to go to 9-7. 9-7. There's Jason and Gary. Cowboys luncheon today in Dallas as they get ready
Cowboys
to pack
gonna be
their
so
bags
this year.
And head to California.
I say that every year, but yet they somehow.
Well, certainly be different without Jason Witten and Des Bryant, Orlando Scandrick, and some other guys who have been here for a long time. But you know, we have a lot of other leaders. And, you know, I think some of the guys that are going to step into those leadership roles learn from a guy like Witt. And I think they're embracing the opportunity. Sean Lee, Travis Frederick, Zach Martin, some of those guys, certainly Dak Prescott. You know, those guys are excited about their opportunity take a strong.
All they're going to have is a run game. That's all you're
going
to have to focus on.
And it'll be fun to see those guys grow into those roles.
Let's do a training camp spotlight now, brought to you by Mitsubishi Motors. The Cowboys in the spotlight. Jane Slater here in studio and inside training camp live in the spotlight as well. It's a lot of turnover. A lot of names he had there on that list.
It's a lot of turnover, and even for myself, who's covered this team, this is now the third season here with NFL Network. I was walking into that locker room during OTAs trying to remember some of them. The wide receivers group, now with Des Bryant gone, has names like Tavon Austin, Allen Hurns, Deontay Thompson, and what are these guys going to do with this Cowboys offense? That's the biggest question as we head into training camp. One of the more intriguing stories.
You ever sit there and wonder, like, does she really know her sports, or does she just know it because it's her job?
They're really not going to know until they get through training camp, but I will tell you this, in talking to the new wide receivers coach, Sanjay Law, he's very excited about this group. He likes their versatility, and even Dak Prescott, when I asked him about this, do you need a number one wide receiver? How are you feeling not having a guy like Des Bryant on the football field? And he said that he likes the fact that not a lot of people know a lot about these guys right now. He thinks it gives them a distinct advantage at this point. So remains to be seen. I mean, you also gotta also account for the guy, the fact, you know, I've got like Jason Witten on the football field, and you've got young guys that are untested, guys like Jeff Swain and Dalton Schultz. And so we'll see how this thing shakes out. This is going to be one of the more intriguing, I think, camps for the Cowboys, because there are so many questions offensively heading into it.
Yeah, they would do unanswered questions. Well, Des might have been the number one receiver. As you said, Witten might have been the number one option. The number one target, that's the offense. We'll talk plenty about the offense.
But only know Randy Gregory because he smokes so much.
Thursday, Jan will be there. But there's Randy Gregory as well. It seems like we're always talking about rushing the passer. They do get Randy Gregory back, which is a huge positive.
He's never been a problem.
And Coach Rodner and Ellen, I spoke this morning about that. He loves the uniqueness of Randy Gregory as a pass rusher. He said, you know, the key for him is he hasn't played football in over a year. This is a guy, he said, it's going back to just the simple things. Things like getting in a stance, getting your keys right. That's not easy. But he says it's special to him to know that this is a guy that's now gotten back involved in his life.
What year is he
in? Be very hands-on with him. His camp told me this morning they submitted the paperwork that the league is now requiring to make sure that he does, in fact, have the support system when he gets back to Dallas. And I'm told that he's been training
Was Randy Gregory the same year as Noah Spence?
He's had a personal trainer at Equinox in LA, and his weight is around 250 right now. And mentally, he had, J.C. Garrett talked about today, he had a conversation with him. He's excited on him. This is a team that has really stood behind him. A lot of them put together letters of support to the commissioner to make sure that Randy Gregory got back in with them. But now you start looking at this defensive line, and you look at some of the additions that the offenses have made in the NFC East. This might be one of the more talented groups on the defensive line they've had in recent years. When you think about it, you've got David Irving, you got DeMarcus Lawrence, and now you're talking about a guy like Randy Gregory. Now, Malik Collins, Garrett saying today he's going to start camp on the pup list, and broken foot. Rod Marinelli's not worried about him. He said this guy always plays through the injuries, but in the meantime, we're going to be keeping an eye on Jahad Ward, who was with the Raiders. This is a guy who had a really good training camp, who might be able to be an inside guy for them, something that Marinelli will be keeping an eye on.
Former draft pick out of Illinois, now getting a second shot here with the Raiders. Randy Gregory coming back as well. Cowboys flying to Southern California. They will be in Oxnard rookies Wednesday, and then veterans in first practice on Thursday. As we continue here on Inside Training Camp Live, coming up, new additions. You know the names, but which of them actually make an impact first? Don't go anywhere.
Still a chance here. It's Willingham. Into the box. Willingham shoots. Was magic. Willingham tucks it in and puts the championship to bed. Sweet dreams.
As long as soccer players celebrate with a slide, you can count on Geico saving folks money. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Pressure! What pressure? The players
are... Oh, that is not going to end well. Shouldn't there be a guard there? Hey, it's my wizard.
Wow. It's Bud Light Lime and Orange season. Saddle my horse, you guys can walk.
Bud Light Lime and Bud Light Orange, brewed with real citrus peels.
Shout out to the Eagles, Super Bowl champ. I'm gonna get out of this. I got 3 weeks of off season. What's that?
There ain't no off-beat football. Stop cooking out the whole town.
You gotta use it. Look, for real, good luck. Stop me next year.
And me. And me. Hey, I'll take that.
That's no right. Cowboys ready to play this football. Watch me.
You can't be clear how much new car you can afford when it's unclear how much you can get for your current car. With pricing tools backed by 90 years of expertise, the Kelley Blue Book Instant Cash Offer can bring things into focus. You can get an offer for your car now. Trade in or cash, you decide. And that's one less step between you and your next car. Kelley Blue Book, your car guy.
Hey, guys.
out some weapons. They shouldn't be explosive.
Breaking news. Drive it. Good stuff. We have all 32 teams covered today.
We're all competitive, and it was fun to be out here.
They are trying to make people earn
budget
every snap they get.
Keep running. Come on.
Yes. That's how you play football. If they are on the field, you are there as well.
Training camp. Prime time.
What's the newest movies the best way possible? With movies on demand from Cox.
Massive. I said, player training camp, prime time.
No heartbeat, we can't protect them.
A Quiet Place, rated PG-13. The best way to watch movies is Movies on Demand from Cox. Just go to Channel 1 to order instantly.
Up, college is hard. Down, those books are heavy.
My sport is football, but my passion is education. So every year, I take promising high schoolers on a college tour to show them that higher education means a brighter future. My name is Namdi Asamoa. I don't just wear the shirt, I live it. You can be a leader, tutor, or mentor, too. Take the pledge at liveunited.org/volunteer.
Beware this.
White people, I swear. Kind of like that. Something like you get jiggy with.
Cousins, Smith, and Tyron, most notably, but there are wide receivers, there are defensive players, and Dominican Sue and Richard Sherman as well. These guys did not change teams. Steve White, Jim Trotter, still here with us. I'm Andrew Siciliano at Inside Training Camp. You actually thought those names were
those right? Because, you know, Nate dropped some beats now. I thought that was Nate.
You thought that was Good Morning Football's Nate Burleson?
I did.
Was,
former Detroit Lions. I thought that was Nate.
I'm told it was PL.
Well, that wasn't Nate. Nate's got bars.
Okay.
Go back and check Nate. Nate, I'm shouting you out. You've got skills. Go back and watch some of his stuff.
Nate, if you're not sleeping, getting ready for tomorrow's show, please call in and drop rhymes. We showed you that list of names, your biggest impact, at least immediately from those.
Well, I was going to say Aqib Talib with the Rams because, you know, look, they needed that veteran dog in the secondary, right? So you get a guy who knows Wade Phillips' system. He comes over. He gets to help Marcus Peters on the other corner. He can play inside. He can play outside. They're in a division where these quarterbacks, Russell Wilson, Jimmy G, they're going to be going after the secondary because the Rams, they've got that interior push-up problem. If they don't have a dominant edge rusher, now they're Robert Crisma. So I'm saying it's Aqib Talib. And here's another name, Sam Shields, who's out of football last year, coming to be that third corner. Watch out for the impact he has on that secondary.
The former Packer, they added three corners, and he's the one that everyone forgets. If he can stay healthy,
oh yeah,
he was pretty darn good in Green Bay before he got hurt.
Yep.
Well, let me piggyback off that, because you're talking about the corners and what they're able to do in terms of taking away receivers on the outside. I'm going to go with Jerick McKinnon, 49ers running back, who was signed from the Vikings. From this standpoint, too, this is one reason I expect him to have a good year. When you talk about the 49ers playing the Rams twice a year, if you've got Talib and Peters who are taking away the outside, the one thing you've got to be able to do is work the middle of the field, and Jimmy G does that really well. McKinnon is an excellent receiver out of the backfield. Kyle Shanahan wanted a back who was dynamic in the passing game as well as the run game. McKinnon gives them that. Now, he's not going to be a 25-30 carry guy per game, but in terms of the all-around play, running, receiving, and the thing that was critical to the 49ers as well is he's not as big as Carlos Hyde was, but they say he plays stronger and bigger in pass protection than you would expect from someone his size.
Isn't it weird there? as well, because Carlos Hyde wore 28 to see Jerick McKinnon there wearing 28. They're totally different backs.
Right. But think Devontae Freeman. Think what Kyle Shanahan did with that dual-purpose type running back in Atlanta, him and Tevin Coleman. If they can have that platoon system up there in San Francisco, Jerick McKinnon's going to be one of these guys at the end of the season. We're going to say,
where did that come from?
Sure. Yes.
And he got paid, by the way, to be that guy. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people raised some eyebrows when they saw the numbers that Jerick McKinnon got in free agency, because free agency money isn't there for that.
No, but you have to understand, too, when people look at players, it's not always just about the player's ability. It's about a coach's ability to put players in positions to be successful. Coaches or even offensive coordinators who can scheme as well or as good as Kyle Shanahan, he will make Jerick McKinnon successful in terms of having a big year this season, because no one does it better than him, in my opinion.
Play callers in that division.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. With Shanahan, with McVay. The season ended last year for the Niners, actually, in L.A. here against the Rams, Week 17. Rams didn't play anybody. Look ahead to Week 17 this year, seeing two teams. It could be fun. Frankly, we haven't even made it to Week 1 of the preseason. I'm talking Week 17 of the regular season. Coming up, Brandon Bourbon A. Hear from the Bears already on the field as they get ready for the Hall of Fame game. It's inside training camp. Football is in the air.
I stand on the shoulders of these great men, and with all of you on this stage tonight, never let others define you. You define yourself. Where would you rather be? And right here, right now.
The Pro Football Hall of Fame Enshrinement Ceremony, Saturday, August 4th at 7, live on NFL Network. Ignite your passions. Explore more. Discover. Embrace adventure. Seek new memories. This summer, drive a Mazda and chase the sun. Spread your wings. Mazda, feel alive.
For real, good luck. Stopping me next year.
And me.
Right.
And me.
You gotta use it. Blue.
Hey, I'll take that.
Watch me.
Why is it after like a touchdown or like an interception we feel that we have to express ourselves?
Because it took a lot to get there.
Instantly lock your Experian credit file with Experian Identity.
Not all the time.
Start free at Experian.com/lock. Identity protection as a new
identity.
Sometimes the ball just falls to you.
Introducing the latest advancements in copper compression garments.
We still gotta celebrate that.
Targeted kinesiology compression bands designed to pinpoint and relieve muscle and joint soreness.
I know, but like, let's just say you're there, the ball just happens to fall on the ground, bounces and goes into your lap, and you catch it. As soon as you get tackled, you're getting up like, yeah, let's go, like you did. I know, like you just. Just recover the fumble or something.
Of course you're going to celebrate recovering the fumble.
Like it fell in your lap and then like people tackled you and you were down. And then you're going to get up like you literally caused the fumble. And then all you did was it just landed on you.
Nigga, it's difficult recovering the fumble. Fucking game to turnover. It ain't a turnover unless I recover that shit. Hey, I'm celebrating. What is wrong with you?
I am too. I'm just saying, what is it that makes us do that? Like, what makes us pump our chest? Like, yeah, but like, come on, man. It's like we have.
Oh, it just fell to me. Or the
niggas thrown me or if I caused it, nigga. If I'm getting a turn, if I caused a turnover, if I'm getting the ball back for my offense, like, nigga, I'm celebrating. You know why? Because I just got an extra million in my motherfucking check for that shit.
Man, I'm just celebrating off of the hype.
Players have the sensors.
I'm just saying, if you were in the, I'm not even talking about you in the NFL, I'm just saying, you're in the park,
hey, remember summer playing vacation?
Football.
Time
like, you're gonna celebrate, exactly, no matter what it is. It's like, if you're competitive, you're gonna celebrate. Like, what is it that makes you have to do something? Like, I don't know.
JJ will have the Texans back on the field soon. We are back on the offense, but now, give me ball, I got ball. For inside training camp live,
I don't know what it is.
Mitsubishi Motors. I'm Andrew Siciliano, Steve Weich, Jim Trotter.
I got the football.
I wasn't fishing, but thank you.
When did they put JJ Watt's face Photoshop on your body?
Oh,
that was
JJ.
Your traps are
pretty tired.
Really?
I'm tired of hearing about JJ Watt.
That's not me.
Stop. Look at
I'm
get
tired
you there.
Of hearing about JJ Watt.
That's not me.
Wine glass.
Man,
yeah, we need to get better.
Let's keep it. We're lifting this.
Like,
okay.
White.
The coffee. There's a lot of news to get to. Let's get to that news, and then we're gonna be live.
Talking.
Coming up shortly, Bourbon A for the Bears here, and they're in training camp. But the number one headline today has to do with Josh Gordon. We awoke to this story this morning. Gordon saying he's not gonna be with his team on Wednesday when they report to Berea. I'm reaching out to you all personally, and this was on Twitter, letting you know that I am not only doing great physically, but mentally as well, as we try to make sense of this Josh Gordon story. You will notice that I will not be in Cleveland for the start here of training camp. Rest assured, this
what is,
too is a part of my
what's going on now with Josh Gordon?
Plan. Gordon says, with the help of the league, the union, and the Browns organization, I've been able to utilize the resources available
illness.
To me that will ensure my well-being on
illness.
And
no,
like
something else. He's not going to, it says, Josh Gordon will not report to training camp, will be placed on non-football illness reserves.
Before the season begins, we believe it'll help me maintain the progress I've made for not only today, but for many years to come. Does. Again, Josh Gordon will continue to support Josh, the Browns say. John Dorsey, GM, as he receives care needed to maintain his progress, we're going to respect his privacy while he's away from the team. Josh will be placed on the non-football illness reserve list until he is ready to return. I said we're trying to make sense of this, Ian Rappaport. You said earlier he hasn't failed the test. Joe Thomas, his former teammate, was sitting at this desk last hour. He gave me the impression that he thinks he hopes Gordon could be back before the season begins.
Satisfying.
What do you say to that?
Yeah, Josh Gordon gave us that same insinuation.
I think everyone has gone through those little videos, bro.
But
oh, yeah. No, have you ever been stuck on the marble ones?
Trying to work your way back.
Yeah, where they have like these long ass races with a whole bunch of little marbles. Like little marbles, and they just have races going like down the trails in the sand, and like, bro, you get stuck. Like, oh, I'm watching like watching the damn race horses and stuff. Like you pick a color, and then you just watch them race.
Kind of remove himself from his teammates and say that he's not going to be ready, not going to be there when camp begins. But very clearly, something happened. We just don't know what. We know he did not fail.
Or what about the thing like that? But the hot knife. No, like the hot knife, like they take a knife just like super hot and it'll slice it through things.
What we do know is that with Josh Gordon, it is all up in the air. We've been here before, waiting for him to be cleared. It looked like he was going to, and then he took a step back and ended up going into a treatment center. That was a couple years ago, and hopefully soon we'll find out some answers on what really happened today. Put Josh Gordon on the outside.
Yeah,
those
should be in the
yeah, we have been here. However, when he came back last year, he did play five games. He stayed on the field, but they were his first games since December of 2014. Week 16, 2014. In Rappaport on top of the story. When we know more, we will give you more.
I don't know if it's
report on Wednesday.
so much destruction, today, but however, just what it is, it's like very soothing. It's real soothing to see something just melt through something like butter, well, or something just squish.
The Bears, meantime, are in Bourbon, Illinois. They actually got outside today, had pads on. Why? Because it's not raining anymore. Matt Nagy wants to see Mitch Trubisky throw that deep ball a little bit better.
His arrow is going up with the deep ball. You know, I think that we got into the OTAs, and there were some times where his mentality coming into this thing wasn't necessarily downfield to start. But he's done a great job of accepting that role. And now we tell him, hey, listen, go down the field, test it, see what you can do, see the different receivers that you're throwing to, and how far you can stretch. Let him know what kind of arm you have.
I kind of 100% agree with that, because
he's improving, and we are not going
to
stop doing.
I found myself lots of times stuck on one of those shows on TV where they show how to make things. I just episode after episode, like. Yeah, I can completely agree with that, because I used to watch things get made all the time.
Pads today, Stace, and the rain stayed away from the Bears.
Indeed, Andrew, it was the first rain-free day. By the way, did you say vacation was over? Because I'm vacationing right now, Bruno. Just to point that out. This,
every day's vacation.
This place is awesome.
Who doesn't
that's right.
What are you doing when you get around? Is there a beach nearby?
I swear we need to buy a stretch of arm.
You know, we've got a Steak and Shake that we're going to head out shortly. My producer and I, that's correct. Craving a chocolate milkshake over here. But listen, hey, practice. Practice was a lot of fun today. Unfortunately, we didn't get to see Allen Robinson out there. He's 100% clear, but he was given a clearance day, if you will, just a day of rest. It was a scheduled day, as was the same for offensive lineman along with Danny Trevathan, with a bit of a hamstring that he's dealing with. But this is a healthy Bears team, and I think, you know, you talked there about the comments from head coach Matt Nagy, guys, back in the studio, and there's an excitement about how aggressive this offense is going to be. It started with Ryan Pace he was able to accomplish, bringing in the likes of a Robinson, Gabriel, Trey Burton, who is all over the place, by the way, much like Travis Kelce in Kansas City, where Matt Nagy came from. But this is a touchdown to check down mentality offensively. These Bears were the worst passing team in the league a season ago, and I can assure you, watching practice today, that football was touched by a number of receivers, and I think they like their depth, that wide receiver. The Anthony Miller draftee, he looks pretty good. And Kevin White, guys, he had a really good day of practice. Maybe the best I've seen here in year four for Kevin White.
Well, they've made a lot of adjustments on offense, when we talk about Matt Nagy and whether or not Mitchell Trubisky is going to take that next step. But for me, with the Bears, too, I think what gets overlooked is that the key signing, a key signing that they made this offseason, was defensive coordinator Vic Fangio.
Thank you.
That unit last year, 10th overall, 9th in scoring, 11th in rushing, 7th in passing.
Like to buy,
Vic Fangio is one of the more underrated coordinators in this league, in my opinion, from a public standpoint. The coaches know how good he is. Now, if they can get Roquan Smith signed, that's only going to make that unit that much better. And hopefully take pressure off of Trubisky to have to perform at an elevated level.
And you so rarely see that. A new head coach comes in and says, yeah, I'll keep the entire defensive staff. It was hanging there in the balance for a day or two.
They passed over him for that job.
Yeah.
So for him to stay, they had to make it a pretty sweet offer.
Fantastic player. Look, one of the things Matt Nagy said in that quote that I love is, you know, you got the strong arm, let it rip. What does that sound like? Alex Smith. Okay, maybe this is what they're going to try to model some things after. What about you?
To buy it.
You shouldn't have.
I'll be back.
They should.